This week's Safety Toolbox Talk is on recognizing hazards. As you can see in front of us, we're using a crane. It's got a 500-600 pound stone rigged, lowering it down to the masons below here to rebuild this parapet up on this roof system. And right on the other side of these tradesmen is supported scaffold all the way around that side of the building, all the way down to the ground. So we have tradesmen working on supported scaffold that's tied into the building, built level on mud sills, and tied into the structure every 30 feet horizontally and 26 feet vertically. So we have a lot of masons here setting very heavy stones. You've got a suspended load over their head. They've got tag lines on it. Very dangerous type of work. And then up here you can kind of take a look at housekeeping. Is housekeeping really in its best order up here as far as staging, or are there apparent trip hazards in major corridors? You know, looking up above here at the dome, we've got gentlemen working up on that dome. Once again, a supported scaffold system, dangerous work, climbing stair towers. The entire thing is tied into the structure, typically 14 inches off the face of the building. But once again, in particular zones underneath those monorails that you see for material hoisting 1,400 pound stones, we need to be tied off in a lot of them circumstances, so we have fall protection issues as a priority up on that dome area. There are so many hazards to be identified in the construction arena. You know, down here we're looking at a haul road all the way down and around, and on that haul road we're using a lull, we're using a bobcat, means and methods of moving around tiered material, some loose material. How secured is it? Remember, one of the ACIG life-saving commitments is securing the loads prior to dropping them in particular areas. We have another area over here that we're showing a ladder for egress. So we have ladder safety. Is it at its 4-to-1 angle? Is it secured at the top, 3 feet over the horizontal plane? There are so many different things to look at in the logistic plan of a construction site. And really what it comes down to also is knowing your environment. Where am I working? What is my task? Is it on that dome? Is it on the ground elevation? Am I operating a mixer down below, an electric mixer? Is my cord in good shape? Am I using a GFCI? What am I doing today? Where am I working? What are my tasks at hand? What personal protective equipment do I need to do my task? What coordination do I need to talk about in my morning safety huddle to eliminate known hazards in my work scope that day? So this week, let's take a look at our jobs and let's talk a little bit about recognizing potential hazards associated with the scopes of work that we're performing, because every scope of work and the environment for that scope of work changes in a day. And remember, the second leading killer in the construction industry is being caught between or struck by material handling and object vehicular traffic wherever you might be working. Let's have a safe week. Thank you.